I've said before, grooming is an art. You have to be really precise. A lot of people think that going down the trail and groom is just going straight. But there is a science to all of this. Moving your snow, compacting it, filling in the hole. Who's Luc Levesque? Just a regular guy that does volunteer work for a snowmobile club. Guy that loves snowmobiling and what goes with snowmobiling. Great people you meet on the trail. Make people smile because you make a nice trail. I'm the groomer guy. What we'll all be riding in. This is our groomer. Really, it's a loaner from the Sault Ste. Marie Club because ours broke down. It's on the trail. They're really nice to let us use their tractor. The back end, it's the drag. The part that you cut to your trail, it's called a drag. And that's what makes your tractor turn. These two hydraulic cylinders, one pushes, one pulls. So if I'm going to turn this way, this one goes in and it pushes. So the back end is making the groomer turn. It's quite the system. A bunch of snowmobilers came into the store, and one of our club members were there, and they came in and started talking to me. He says, "It's our first time here," and this and that. And I asked him, "How did you learn about Dubreuilville?" "About your blog. We were following your blog. We decided to load up the sleds and come riding up here. I'm on municipal council here. It's been my third term. And I'm on the snowmobile club here in Dubreuilville."
So now we're leaving Dubreuilville. So we're going to be gone probably about 6 or 7 hours. We won't see much anything. There's no cell phone. Just a CB radio that I have right here. And when we're in the power line tonight, it won't do anything because the interference of the power line, you can't call out. In the old days, I had no way of communication. I could be gone for 18, 20 hours, and if I was really far, I couldn't even have radio communication. I was on my own. Because you want your trail to have no traffic over it until it sets up. So we go at night. The temperature usually is colder at night. The toughest part of the year is when we're starting. Like, we got lots of holes to fill in. You got to push some snow, cut your brush, because the brush is the worst. It grows so fast, it's unreal. It's 17 years of working trails, grooming, putting up signage, cutting brush. It never stops. There's always something to be in. You have to do.
I have never seen that. The trails were nice. We went to a restaurant for about an hour and a half. We had to backtrack a little bit on the trail. Came back, was all trash and all mud and snow all the way. It's like always on alert, like you're tense because you never know if one guy's going to turn the curve and hit you. Yeah. So I was all nervous all the time. Yeah, we got people, Ohio, Michigan, Indiana, Minnesota. We got Russia, Germany, there's Sweden. There's even places where there's not even snow. Seems like people, they want to see a crazy Canadian. They're going to the bush and snowmobiling and the grooming trails.
Actually, we have members as far away as Texas, Indiana, Ohio, Wisconsin. Trails are so well maintained compared to Michigan. And up here, it's as flat as this tabletop, 14 foot wide. And you know, a lot of it is you. You know, you put a lot into the trails. A lot of yourself. You take a lot of pride, and it shows.
I'm grooming that trail like I'm going to be riding it the next day.
When a snowmobile hits a curve, people tend to press more on the gas. So by doing that, it pushes the snow up in the curve. So what we do is I'll angle my plow, and then I'll grab the snow, and you bring it back to the center. You should see this spot. It's so bad in the summer, ATVs don't even want to go over this. You'll think you're driving almost like on a paved road. So, must be around 6 o'clock in the morning. We've groomed all into the night on our way back home.